Hello everyone, you are welcome back to Bioscience Class Channel. Today is the second lecture in the study of lipid biochemistry. With the first lecture, we talked about lipids, we defined lipids, we talked about some characteristics of lipids, we talked about the classifications under lipids, that we said we have terpenes, steroids, eicosanoids, sphingolipids, cerebrosides, and other derived lipid compounds. So we also talked about the biological importance of lipids, that we said they are useful in absorption of vitamins and other minerals and so many. So if you don't have the video or you've not studied that part, you can check the comment section or the description so that I will leave the video link so that you can go back and read it before you come back to terpenes. So today we are going to talk about terpenes. And we said terpenes is one of the classifications under lipids. So terpenes, they are natural products. So they are natural products that are structurally related to isoprene. So terpenes, they come from the name terpentine. So if you heard that name, it's from terpenes. So they are structurally related to isoprene. So we have isoprene units in terpenes molecules. All right, so isoprene is a compound and it's having the molecular or the chemical formula 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. So it's actually a 2 conjugated double bonds. So the structure of isoprene unit, we are going to talk about it in the few minutes. So you get the structure very well and you know how to identify those isoprene units. So example of terpenes include in plants and animals include, we have limonene, we have carotenoids, we have pheromones, squalene, we have beta carotene, we have gibberellic acid, and etc. So these are examples of terpenes and they are natural products from plants and animals, as you can see. So terpenes may contain 2 or more isoprene units. So you talk about the isoprene units in the later slides. So isoprene units, they are found in terpenes. So every terpene contains or have an isoprene unit. Okay, so all these natural products from animals and plants, they have their specific purposes. So they serve as function in either plant or animal. So we are going to talk about the importance of all these terpenes in plants and animals. Okay, so let's talk about the importance of some terpenes in plants and animals. So the first terpene, so we have beta carotene. So this is carotene and this gives color in carrots. So if you've seen a carrot before, the color of these carrots are being given by a terpene called beta carotene. All right, so it's specific and it gives color in carrots. The next terpene is lycopene. So lycopene is also the red pigment found in tomatoes. So the red pigment is also given by a terpene called lycopene. We also have pheromones. So this is chemical released by insects to attract sex partners. So when ants and other insects, they are ready to have, let's say, mating or sexual affair, then one of the insects will release this chemical called pheromone and it will serve as an attractant to the other partner so that it will also know that it's time for them to mate. So it will attract them and they will have their mating. So this pheromone is also a terpene. As I said, they are found in plant and animals. So both animals and plants can have it. So it's chemical released by insects to attract sex partners. We also have another one called squalene. So it's an intermediate in steroid synthesis. So I talked about steroids in the first lecture in the study of lipids. So steroids, they are precursors. So as you can see, this is an intermediate. So in the synthesis of steroids, so these steroids are also used in the synthesis of some hormones. So we are going to talk about it in the later slide. So let's move on to the next terpene. We have limonene. Limonene also gives other to citrus fruits. So oranges, tomato, oranges and mango, we have oranges and we have tangerines. So all those citrus fruits, the odor that comes from them are given by this terpene called limonene. Okay, so when you press the outer covering of the citrus fruit, you can see that some juicy substance will come out and it gives that odor. So those odors come from the terpene called limonene. We also have gibberellic acid. This is also a growth hormone and it's found in plants only. Okay, we also have carotenoid. Carotenoid is a light absorption pigment, so it absorbs pigments in plants during photosynthesis or any other process. So we have so many pigments in plants. We have chlorophyll, we have carotenoids and others. So carotenoid is also a light absorbing pigment in plants. Okay, so let's talk about the classification of terpenes. Okay, let's talk about the classification of terpenes. So terpenes are classified according to the number of isoprene units. So the earlier slide I talked about isoprene units. Terpenes are classified according to the number of isoprene units they have. So they can be cyclic, they can be open chain, they can have double bonds and other groups in it. All terpenes are constructed by head to tail, that's the end closer to the metal group. So you can see this structure. We have head here and we have tail here. So the part closer to the metal group is called the head and the latter end is called the tail. So as I said, terpenes, they have an isoprene structure which was 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. So this is the structure I was talking of. So the butadiene means they are having two pi bonds, but they are not conjugated. So 2 pi bonds in it. Alright, so all terpenes are constructed by head to tail. The end closer to the metal end is called the head, and the latter end is called the tail. So these are examples of isoprene units. So this is an isoprene, this is also an isoprene, but this is how the head and the tail are being classified. Okay, so these are the classification of terpenes. We said that terpenes are classified according to the number of isoprene units, but with the normal numbering, this differs a little. So we have monoterpenes. So monoterpenes, they have 2 isoprene units. So it's not like the normal numbering that we have mono, that means 1. No, in terpenes, when we say monoterpenes, that means they have 2 isoprene units. When we say they are sequesterpene, that means we have 3 isoprene units. When we say they are diterpene, that means they have 4. Triterpene, that means they have 6 isoprene units. Tetraterpene means they have 8 isoprene units. Polyterpene means they are 3,000 and 6,000 above isoprene units. So these are some examples of the terpenes with each class. So for monoterpenes, we have citral. For sequesterpene, we have ferritin. For diterpene, we have phyto. For triterpene, we have squalene, which is the examples of terpenes that we talked about. Tetraterpene, we have beta carotene, and polyterpene, we have rubber. So rubber is a synthetic polymer. So this is a polymer, that means we have polyterpene. So there are many terpenes in rubber. So it's easier to get it. Okay. So let's talk about how to identify some isoprene units. So this is an isoprene unit, this is an isoprene unit, this is isoprene. But how can you identify isoprene unit from, let's say, a compound or a terpene? So the terpene, you can be asked to identify how many isoprene units they have. So you have to know how to identify each isoprene unit in a terpene structure. So we said we have the head and the tail. and the head is the end closer to the metal group, and the tail is the other end. So from the head, you count four carbons. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you strike here. So this is one isoprene unit. As you can see, they've identified it with a black color. So the red sign here means we are cutting the end over here. So this is not part of the group. So when we are starting from another isoprene unit, we will start from here. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. So if there was another carbon here, then we will cut it over here. That means this will not be part. So this is the head and this is the tail. So we start counting from the head, the part with the metal group attached. So that's how we identify isoprene. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you cut. So this is the head and this is the tail. Okay. So how to identify isoprene unit? So as I said earlier, as you can see from here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So we count 1, 2, 3, 4, and take note in the characteristics of terpenes. We said they can have double bonds, they can have single bonds, they can be cyclic. So don't be confused that this is not having a double bond, but the normal isoprene unit is having a double bond. There can be a double bond. There can also be the absence of double bond. So take note. So just have to count from the parts closer to the metal end. So as you can see here, we have a metal group here. So you can start counting from 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you cut. So 1, 2, 3, 4, then you cut. But you must make sure that the head is closer to the metal group. So as you can also see from here, 1, 2, that means there is this metal group over here. So the metal group should be carbon 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you cut the next one, 1, 2, 3, 4. But make sure that the one is closer to the metal group, which will be carbon 5. Then you cut 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you cut. So the OH group is not part of the isoprene unit. So as you can see here, you have one that's closer to the metal group. So one, or this can also be one, while this will be the metal group. So one can be here, one can be here, then 2, 3, 4. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, because this is one, is the reason why this is one is it is closer to the metal group. So that's how we identify isoprene units. All right, so if you don't get it, just rewind the video and make sure you get the understanding very well. Okay, so let's try this and let's identify the number of isoprene units. So we have this structure over here. We don't know what the structure or the number of isoprene units it contains, so that we can classify it, whether it's sequesterpene, diterpene, monoterpene, triterpene, tetraterpene, or polyterpene. Alright, so we've been asked to identify the number of isoprene units. So let's try. I said we start from the part closer to the metal group. So this can be a metal group. This can be a metal group. So we can choose to start from one here or one here. So if we start one here, this is will be 5. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is an isoprene unit. Then we will cut over here. So we'll cut it over here. Then we will start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because we can start from here, one is that we have a metal group over here. So a metal group is here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 2 isoprene units over here. So this molecule or this compound is a monoterpene. So it contains 2 isoprene units. You can check the table back there. 2 means mono. So we have a monoterpene. So let's try this also and you will identify this yourself. I also give you a trick at the end of this video to identify them with ease. So let's start. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. And you know the reason why we started from here as 1, because it's closer to the metal group over here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, then we cut. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we cut. So we have two isoprene units. It's also a monoterpene. Okay, so the trick that I'm giving to you at the end of this video is, in order to determine the number of isoprene units, it's not always true, but you have to get it at the back of your mind so that it will help you to identify them with ease. So when you check, you have to count the number of metal groups, the metal substituent in that compound. So this, for this one particular, we have two, we have one here, we have one here. So we have two metal group substituent. So it's likely we can have two isoprene units. As you can see here, we have two metal substituent, two metal substituent, two metal substituent. So this is one. I think this is one. This can be one, two. So we have two metal substituents. So it's likely it's going to be a monoterpene. It's going to be having two isoprene units. So that those are the tricks that you can use to identify them. If you have the understanding too, you can try and identify them yourself without any difficulties. So this is terpene and this is isoprene unit. So every terpene molecule has an isoprene unit within it. There is no terpene that we cannot have an isoprene unit. Every terpene must have an isoprene unit. So this is terpene for you. And we are going to treat steroids on the next video. So stay tuned. If you've not watched the lipids, the link will be in the description. You can check on it. Make sure you leave a comment on this video if you don't have the maximum understanding, or if you have any difficulties, you can also let us know in the comment section. Make sure you like this video, you comment, you share, and if not subscribed to this channel, make sure you do so that you will get any uploads when we give any video up. So thank you very much for watching this video. Have a nice day.